From glory to glory.
First Chronicles 29, verse 10 to 13. Wherefore David blessed the Lord before all the congregation, and David said, Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For all that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord. And thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come of thee, and thou reignest over all, and in thine hand is power and might. In thine hand it is to make great and to give strength unto all. Now, therefore, our God, we thank thee and praise thy glorious name. Let's read that verse 13 together. One, two, go. Now, therefore, our God, we thank thee and praise thy glorious name. Amen. Romans chapter 10. We'll pick it up. Especially, we're going to look at verse 17. So then, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Say that with me. Say it again. Say it again. I want you to make that verse one of your friends. The just shall live by faith. That is the only verse that is repeated four times in the entire Bible. The just shall live by faith. The just. From Habakkuk, the just shall live by faith. 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 This convention that we just ended and has just begun really in our lives. 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 12. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called, and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. Fight the good fight of faith. Say it seven times. How does faith come? And what kind of hearing? Okay, so if faith comes by hearing the preaching and teaching and singing and ministry of the Word of God, why must we fight the fight of faith? What is so important about faith that we're told there is no place we are told to fight the devil in the Bible? Not one place. He said, resist the devil and he will flee. Correct? Yes. Am I correct? So why do we need to fight the fight of faith? I thought the Bible would tell us to fight the devil. He says, be careful or beware or that your adversary, the devil. So the devil is our adversary. John 10 verse 10, the thief cometh but for to steal, to kill, and destroy. But there's no place we are told to fight the devil. He's our adversary. And like a roaring lion, he goeth about looking for whom he may devour. Correct?
Yes.
So if the devil is our enemy, why are we not told to fight him? Why are we fighting? Why are we told to fight the fight of faith? He says, for our warfare, even when he's okay, Pastor, but he says our warfare is not, he says our warfare is not carnal, but mighty through God. There is down strongholds and pulling down all these things, and there's no place we're told to fight the devil. He said, whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. He didn't mention the devil. So why are we now told to fight? First of all, we're Christians. Huh? We're not supposed to fight because we're Christians, right? We're supposed to be men of peace and women of peace, right? And bear spiritual fruit. Huh? Meekness and gentleness and patience and kindness and long suffering. Remember? Are you still here?
Huh?
Galatians 5. So why are we now told to fight? And then of all fights we're permitted to fight, we're now told to fight the fight of faith. So obviously there must be something big about faith. So write it down. There must be something so huge about faith that of all fights, God is asking us to fight the good fight of faith. There must be something about faith. So that's the title tonight. There must be something about faith. Or what is so dangerous about faith? What is so dangerous about faith? That's a good title. What is so dangerous about faith that God is asking us that, look, this is the only fight, and it's called a good fight. So write this down. If there is a good fight, there must be a bad fight. And here we are given the injunction to fight the good type of fight. And the good type of fight is the fight of faith. So question is, what is so remarkable about faith that the devil hates it so much and God loves it so much that we're advised and counseled and instructed and authorized to fight the good fight of faith? What is so dangerous about faith? So if faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God, so faith comes when the word is preached or taught, correct? So if the devil, if he say he has any sense, and I believe he does, then he will fight what feeds faith, which is the word of God. So the real enemy of faith is, the real target of the enemy is the word of God. Correct? Because in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was made flesh, and the Word dwelt amongst us, and the Word became flesh, and we beheld him. John chapter 1, and he became flesh, and we beheld him, and he's the Son of God, and all of that, you know that. So when the devil is fighting faith, he's fighting the Word of God, correct? And the Word of God is Christ, correct? And without the word, nothing can be done. Because everything is made by the word of God. Correct? Because in the beginning, God said, let us. So the very material with which he made heaven and earth was by the word, by speaking. Correct? So the word of God is the building material of God. When God wants to build, he uses his word. Let there be light. He didn't need to manufacture light and bring a yellow light and this. He just said, let there be light. And light found him itself and then came out. And later we found there are seven colors in one light, in light. The spectrum. Correct? So when God wants to, so the biggest work of God is to speak. God's biggest job is to speak. That's his work. God's work is to speak. Let there be light. There was light. Let there be this. There was that. Let there be this. So when God wants to create, let me ask you this question, see if you can get it. I mean, I'm sure you know. When God wants to create, what does he use? His word. The word. Not just his word. The word. Correct? Okay. When God wants to give you money, what does he do? He speaks. Why doesn't he give you money? Cash. Huh? Yeah, what is in his word that will give me money? I need to pay rent now. You're telling me, God said. They're coming to take my car tomorrow morning. You're telling me, God said. What do you mean, God said? How will God's word bring me money right now? Somebody needs healing. He's dying. You're giving him the word of God. God said in the beginning, he sent his word and healed them, and his word delivered them, and by the stripes of Jesus, is that what he needs? I'm trying to bring it to your living room. You're having a headache now. You're saying God said. When there's Tylenol in this thing. Huh? So why would God give us his word when we need something? Go to Hebrews 11. I'm trying to make you think. Hebrews 11. Verse 6, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, comma, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. We know that verse by memory, don't we? Look at that. This is where we miss it. Should I show you where we miss it?
Yes.
But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God. Underline that word, cometh. He that cometh to God must believe. Underline believe. That he is. So, first of all, it's a choice. He that chooses, he that decides, He that has prioritized going to God. He that prefers. He that has looked up, search high and low, can't find nobody. He, it is a choice. Number one, it's a choice. Number two, he that cometh or that goeth to God. Another choice. You can believe and choose not to. He that goeth or cometh to God. He that decides that, man, I'm going to God, no other. Did you see that? Am I helping you? Huh? Now look at me. We go to God with props and backups and option B and plan B and A and C. If this doesn't work, then this, because this God, I don't know, maybe, you know, let me just pray in case. So we usually go to God after we've tried other things. Let's read it again. For without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God. No, hold it. He that cometh to who? To God. Not to my friend. Not to my neighbor. Not to the bank. Not to my wife or husband, not to my friend. He that does what? To God. We are trained and raised to come to somebody. No. When a child is hungry, does he go to God? Who does he go to? So how can you not? So we are raised to go to somebody. You go to the father. The father says, go to your mom. Go to your mom. Leave me alone. I'm reading my newspaper right now. Or I'm listening to the radio. Or I'm watching TV. Go to your mom. Go to your mom. Take. Go to your mom. Let her give you whatever you want. I'm talking to my friend. That's how some of our fathers, you say, look, here's, go and buy something. Go. Drive you away. So you go to your mom. Your mom says, go to your older sister. Go. Go to the kitchen. Who is there? Give him whatever he needs. This child. So they pass you from hand to hand until somebody gives you something. So we are raised to go to someone. Are you getting my point? After we've gone to many, and then we just say, and then somebody says to you, why don't you try God? Have you prayed? Say, prayed, but okay. If you say, let's go to Glory House, there's one pastor, you say, yes, but I'm telling you, let's just go. You know how many pastors have prayed? Okay, if you say so, I will go, I will come. I've been hearing about that man. Yes, go. He said, there's glory to glory. He said, let's go. Let's see. Well, God, I'm here.
That is wrong. Without faith, let's say it again, it is impossible to please him. No, he didn't say please God. Yeah. Without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is a rewarder of them that do. See, I'm trying to make you learn it. After you settle, remember we're talking about cometh. And then we're talking about to God. Must believe. What does it mean to believe? Yes, I believe, Pastor. Yeah, I believe. I believe that God loves me. I believe. What does it mean to believe? Pastor, I know it, but I don't know how to say it. I just know that believe is believe. I used to be like him. I don't know the words, but I know that belief means to believe. Pastor, you know now, you know what I mean. If I said to you now, there is I won't say a lot of money, there is $5,000 in a Kroger bag at the back of the church, in the trunk of a red car, whoever first gets there, just tap the trunk 3 times, it will open, take the $500. How many of you will go?
5,000.
You see? Do you see? You see how desperate some of us are? Some to them, 500 is too little. They just failed the test. If it's a woman, most women, not in this church, they will rush to that door and then say, this rain, my hair. See that? My hair. Second thing, I want to go, but my hair, my clothes, my shoes, it's raining. All right, let me look for an umbrella or something and cover my hair. Correct? Are we talking real talk today? I keep it real. Yes. Most mothers will say to their child, "So now, can't you see it's raining? Why are you rushing to? Go inside. No, I don't want you to fall sick." And most men will tell their wives, "Be easy, take it easy. Is it 500 you want to? Stop running like that. What do you want? Must you go?" It's all natural. This is what I'm trying to get across to you. Reasoning. Believing. The enemy of belief in God is reasoning. The enemy of faith is reasoning. Thinking about it until it makes sense to you. At your level, with your small head, compared to God's infinite wisdom. So, believing means accepting what God said first before thinking about it and trying to understand it. Because your reasoning and your wisdom and your sense will kill it. And once it's killed, it's no more faith. You think it through, and then you believe after you think it through, and you say, "Yeah, Pastor, I think it's making sense, yeah." There is somebody here, if you go out there now, there's $1 million floating in the yellow bag on Lawrence. $1 million. How did it come about? Is it fake money? Is it drug money? Is it a trap? Is Pastor kidding? In this rain? What is the probability of $1 million lying in the street? Are you sure it's not a trap? It may be a trick. Pastor must be kidding. Does he mean Pastor doesn't mean $1 million? If I were him, I would go get it first before I tell anybody. I mean, that's what I would think if I was a member of a church like that. You see, as you're reasoning it and trying to reason it out and filter it by your spirit and your head and your mind and your thinking process, you lost it. So if you now convince yourself that it's true, then you jump up and start running to Lawrence Way Highway. If you convince yourself that Pastor is kidding, man, there's no way, even if he means it, he missed it. This is maybe his spiritual language and $1 million. In fact, some will sit and spend the money before they go out to get it. Did you see that? That is the killer of faith. Huh? Can I go deeper?
Yes.
So your biggest warfare is not in the night. It's not with witches and wizards. They are there. The biggest warfare of every believer is in his head. That's why God sends his word. There's no magic in his word. Write this down. The word of God is sent to persuade us to believe what God said totally, completely, without processing it or thinking it through. So the word of God is his tool or instrument with which he persuades us. Well, he tries so hard to persuade us. God doesn't have to give you a word. He can touch you in a dream and get you healed. He can send you a miracle and all that. There are many ways God can answer your prayer. He can have your pastor pray for you and you get healed and get delivered. So it's not often he sends his word. But it is to persuade you. So the word of God is to wash away the reasoning, to disable the way you disable your phone or shut it off in church, I hope. The word of God disables your mind from functioning in order for God's word to enter and feed your faith. In other words, the word of God now disables your mind and pulls you out to believe God before you think about it. Does that make sense? So the word of God is sent to you to disable that mind. The word of God is sent primarily to the mind.
TV is brought to you by faithful partners from around the world. Please visit us on our website at www.glorytoglorychurch.org. Please follow us on Facebook and Twitter. We would love to hear from you.